you know, what the hell? Get out of society. This is the way we're made. There's men and women, and there's flirtation, which, you know, that's how families are formed, right? You like somebody and you get like, ooh, goo goo, let's go out, hold hands or whatever. I guess when it's unwanted, like, oh, well, you have this, some kind of authority over somebody, and that's a cause for sexual harassment. But he vehemently denied, and then he would not step down. I mean, you can't just accuse somebody and say, you gotta just get fired. That's ridiculous. It's insane. That's not what our country is founded on. My God, we should have that basic right, our constitutional rights. That's why the founding fathers set down these rules. You cannot be accused. You cannot have double jeopardy for no good freaking reason. The government can't persecute you for no reason. They cannot persecute out of your lands. But that's a total reason. That's a totally believable and a scam by these so-called deep state, the Jerry Brown, the George Soros, that to try to burn us out of our homes. Yeah, if you've seen this, look at this map they put out as a high red flag. If you didn't know what they say red flag, I think it's false flag. You know, when you fight the war on naval ships and they put on a false flag that pretend they're part of your team, and when you get closer, they boom, 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 fired at you. So these are false flags the government is putting out. And Agenda 21 is to drive you out of your homes so they can put you, what, like in a concentration camp so you're like rats. And to flood this place was illegal. So this way that you are powerless. They don't want you to have power. This is the way the globalists are. All right, they want to be in control of everything. But by the grace of God, I've shown you my heart was like really windy and everything. The wind have ceased, but they're still at it. They're still doing this, oh, burning, burning this, burning that. All of a sudden, poof, that fire started. Microwave energy, it doesn't take much. It takes a quarter of a watt of a laser to light, boom, a match. And they have billion watts in California of these laser energy. Lucky Martin, California. How convenient. And blame it. This Governor Moonbeam, Jerry Brown, blamed it on global warming. Why don't we global warm your ass out of Sacramento, huh? Huh? I say that it's about time for you to pack up your shit and leave. Nobody's above the law. There's the two-term limit. I don't get it. How does he get four terms? This is treason. You have like somebody like Jerry Brown in there for too long, and he's the king now. He's too comfortable. He has to conquer more lands. Oh, they're never happy. Gazillions of dollars are never happy. And they raise the gasoline tax on top of what we're paying right now. Another 12 cents per gallon already right now, all the way up to 2020, it's gonna be 80 cents per gallon. So the scam is, I've seen people disabled, their cars are disabled right in the parking lot. They just can't start it because there's no gas. They can't get themselves a freaking gallon of gas. I know, supposedly Christmas cheer and all that, it doesn't sound cheerful. Because they're at war. We cannot just like, you know, oh, surrender. Because they're mad that Donald Trump is up the economy and undoing the damages that this Obama have done. And if you're blinded, it's not about the race. It's about what they do to you to make your life miserable. That's what the globalists wanted. The globalists that like through Obama have this open policy, and oh, don't you dare talk about Muslims. So we have a bunch of you know, in Michigan, so you have like these areas that it's called no-go zones. We're becoming like Europe. We can't deal with that. And that's why people say we're fed up. And Donald Trump got in there, the economy's looking up, but guess what's going on? They have a bunch of direct energy attacks. They could do that. You know, the freaking snow and this fire, why is it just California? Why is it that severe winter? Oh, blame it on so-called global warming. No, I blame it on you. We gotta just drag these bad guys out and destroy all these so-called weapon energy that's aiming at us. They're supposed to be aiming at North Korea and our enemies, but they're aiming at us. Because we have the enemy from within, George Soros. Remember that. He make money when your country go down because he short our futures of countries. So, what is my prayer? I don't want to just vainly say, oh, Merry Christmas, ho, ho, ho. I'm Miss Santa, but I am a gift from the Lord that I'm praying fervently that all these will be exposed, and I believe that they're being exposed right now in Capitol Hill. And I just said that this death of Dan Johnson is fishy because, you know, this tax cut thing, it's in the so-called reconciliation or conciliation, not reconciliation, mode. It means that when the Senate has their version of the tax cut and the House has their version, both passed. And now, of course, you know, the demo rats, Pelosi says this is bad for the people or whatever. Don't believe that. If you were forced into this mandated, you know, just like Obama mandated you to take the pill, you know, don't take the pill. All right, this ACA, so-called affordable, it's not affordable. Everybody knows that. That's why they put all the Republican people in the Congress. But for some reason, I know it's not no coincidence. Once they get in, they talk the good talk. But we're short by one vote. Last time was with John McCain. Oh, it's really hard once people are, you know, they get this freebie. It's not no freebie. Somebody's paying for this shit. So we said that we don't want that, and the mandate people are paying thousands of dollars because they're punished for not wanting to have insurance. You see, that is gotta come off. And that's why we see this big fight and these lies about all of a sudden, oh, Dan Johnson is dead, so he can't cast the vote. We're gonna be short. Oh, and then today Rubio is gonna defect. So there's always a defector. And I am fed up. I rebuke this lies, lying spirit behind the Republican Party in Jesus' name, because we put them in there to do the job. The tax reform, the tax cut, have them pass. I don't care you're dead or alive. So Rubio, there's my warning. You better not defect. And my warning to McConnell, these people that have tried successfully bring down Roy Moore. It's all rigged from inside. So we're on to you. I mean, of course, Nancy Pelosi and Schumer, those nutcases, we already know. All right, but we're on to you. So don't you dare. And we command that tax cut to go through and no DACA. We don't want to have to fund 2 million illegals so they can stay here and leech off of us to take benefits, medical benefits, and to take money for their housing. You know, these people are used to getting their EBTs. That's why they're here. If you don't give them welfare, they probably won't be here. That's a thing. And I heard this, this is really good. One American, I know I'm just holding on to this because, I don't know, this is like, because my flag, I gotta put it back to where it belongs. So One American Network, there's a show called The Ledger. Graham Ledger, I think this is genius what he said. It's worth repeating. Okay, so if you're saying now we have this so-called children, they're not children, they're 30 some years old, DACA, the dreamers. Oh, sounds good. Oh, you're a dreamer. Yeah, you can smoke your popcalolo, your marijuana, and you know, I have to foot the bill and then I get freaking lung cancer. No, it does not work that way. Dreamers, go home. Go home. You dream over there. I don't dare to dream over to take over everything that you got. Don't you dare to dream to come and take everything I got and demand to kick me out of my homes. Just like, you know, when we start protesting, we get onto this Jerry Brown, he start to burn us. So Grant says, why don't we get the data and have ICE has all the data of these so-called DACA people. Oh, they were supposed to be the children of the sponsor, the illegals, right? Those people that broke into this country. I mean, come on, you try to obey the law. I hope you do. I mean, you don't break into other people's homes. I hope that's you. But if people break into your homes and you go, that's okay, something wrong with you. Nothing wrong with me. It's not because, oh, I'm still supposed to be tolerant. No, bullshit. They come in here, then they demand everything from you. And then they say, well, they pretty much put a shackle on you. If you don't pay for our food, our lodging, and our medical expenses, medical marijuana or whatever, right? Then they're gonna fucking put you in jail. This is not right. That's not America, for crying out loud. So why don't we round up the so-called the parents, the sponsors, because somebody filed for the so-called the Dreamer DACA's, right? They're 30-some years old. They're not kids. Like, you know, because Obama just tried a little bit at a time. Oh, yeah. He said, like, oh, the border will be open for all your people to come in and blah, blah, blah. And he was saying that it's because there's gang violence in South America, whatever. But they're gangsters. There are a lot of this MS-13 people. So why don't we deport? Why don't we get the sponsors, the so-called the parents or whatever, whoever applied for them? Because the chain migration thing, you know, it's just, it's a nothing but a fucking headache. You know, it's like, oh, so everybody come in. Remember one terrorist, like 23 of the terrorists? Why do we need fucking 23 terrorists? I don't need it. I don't need fucking terrorists to come into my house or my country. So why don't we round them up? The applicants, because they're here illegally. It means that they broke the law. If they break into your house, they break the law. You have the right to call the police. And now Jerry Brown says, no, you don't have the right to call the police. That he hinders the enforcement of immigration laws, ICE agents, and, you know, that's what caused the death of Steinle, Case Steinle, and that's just a very famous case, but they're happening every day. They're probably people getting killed and getting raped and ripped off without you knowing it. MS-13 gangs. Anyways, it's horrible. So get the parents, you know, from that list, the DACA list, get the sponsors and get them out of here. And maybe the so-called the dreamers, they will just follow them. And I think that's genius. That's smart. So I'm waiting for some answers to my prayers. Therefore, I can have a Merry Christmas. I don't know about you. And I hope that it's the same spirit, not blindly, just so, oh yeah, everybody come into my house and party, but who's gonna pay for this party? And then they defecate, they urinate, and you know, if this is a big fucking truck, maybe that's one of those, the illegal coyotes shipping, you know, tents. My God, who knows? They're dumping off, that's why they're illegal. I mean, when I say illegal, they camp out there because they just dump them off since we're so close. I start to talk like a New Englander. They dump them off on the bottom of the boulevard. And then, you know, what happens is all these people just go set up camps. That's how they start cooking. I've seen them on Barham. They start cooking there. They just hike up there. They just hike up, like, you know, right there, right behind there. I'm not telling them to hike up, but this is what happened with Jerry Brown, with this open policy to flood us with all these people that are here illegally to take over our land. So I'm sounding an alarm. I say Jerry Brown has to go and shut this stupid door, shut down this DACA, and pass that freaking tax bill and stop killing my senators and my House representatives, and you will pay for the blood of Dan Johnson. You know who you are. You know who you are. All right.